check this out. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. Check this out. Bink. That's right. You know, I just realized that I never talked about my bed that I did for the van in any of my build vlogs. So here we go, we're gonna do that now. So right now I am doing some finishing touches on the van that I'm getting it ready. I am filming this at the end of February. It's actually the last day of February, believe it or not. Head out of town to bring this down to Tiny Fest, California, an event that I have been doing for years that I absolutely love doing. I usually am a speaker at the event. The bed is a slatted bed system. I'll get to this here in a second. This is 80-20 right here. It's a 1-inch 80-20. I had it left over from my Jeep build. It was just a nice find that I had, but I probably would have used either tubed aluminum or 80-20 in this scenario. If you are watching this before Tiny Fest, not bringing Glacier to that event. She is only 3 months old. It is a very overstimulating an event for a three-month-old puppy. She is very acclimated with groups of people and things like that. However, it would be best for her training and everything I'm trying to do with her that she does not attend Tiny Fest with me. So I am leaving her with my buddy Shane. Thank you to Shane. What I did was is I cut in a 1-inch notch here for the 80-20. And then I did another one back here. I bolted the 80-20 right into the wood here, and it just sits in there. So this is extremely strong, and I've got two bars going across in the back here. I just installed some lights underneath here. The power is off, so let me go turn the power on. Tedious work. I've pretty much taken the last month off to kind of focus on Glacier being a good dog dad and all that stuff, so really haven't done much. I added a piece of trim down here during the build process. I told you guys that I was gonna do a shelf right here. I did do a shelf right over there, which we'll get a close-up in a second. I decided not to do one there last minute, just allow for change and let it happen. It's all good. Did the passenger door, booyah, with all the slats on it. I gotta finish that off today. We put the power on here. There we go. These are removable and they go for the bed. Now, normally if you were to like lift up the mattress, you would take that out, put that there so you can get down into this area and then move it back. I want it fully removable. I did not want it sliding. I mean, the other option was to have it slide. I didn't want it to like open up that way because the mattress is on top and it's moving the mattress and getting underneath here is kind of a pain from inside from where I am. So I wanted to make it easy enough so I can just move it over, boom, get into what you need to get into, whether it's like a jackets, you know, area or where you put like dog food or something like that. Same thing with on this side. This one has a little more room. I gotta clean it out, but it has a little more room down in there. I removed the mattress so I can actually put a false bottom in down here. The heater is down in there and I don't know if you can see that in the light, the current light, but it's down in there. I want to create a false bottom, so there's going to be a platform right here. Now that I'm looking at it, it actually might be two platforms because there's no way that I can get a platform into that space now that I've built it all out. Oops, not a big deal. Now you live, you learn, right? Oh, this is the shelf. This is the little shelf that I did. Wait until I put some Osmo on that thing. This is like a little spice rack and it's got that end grain. It's matching this end grain here. All right, let me go to the back so I can show you those lights that I installed in the back. This, wow, this is, look at how much light that is. It's so bright. That is so nice. The little things is really what makes a huge difference in a van build. Honestly, I'm just kind of taking today, the rest of the day today, to kind of finish up these last things, put that false bottom in, finish up the door. I will put it up for sale at that point. Yeah, so we're gonna be ready to go. And then I'm gonna head down to, like I said, I'm gonna head down to Tiny Fest and maybe sell it down there. We'll see what happens. I like this van a lot though, I really do. Wait until you guys see what I do with the tiny home. Ooh, yeah. Let's finish off the vlog with, I don't know, something else. I'll record something later on this week. My Sunday vlogs to be kind of just like me kind of going around and doing my thing, so. All right, everybody, before I finish out the vlog, just give me a couple minutes to talk to you guys about Waggle, because I've talked about them before, but I really want to talk about them again. I think a lot of van lifers or anybody in the RV industry or anybody that really has a pet like I do now, a little Glacie, you guys will understand how I believe important this is. Talked about another product in a video that I did recently, which was Got Stolen GPS. That is a GPS system, but for me, because this van was stolen at one point, having a GPS system in a van is, I think, pretty essential, but having a backup is even better. So Waggle actually has a GPS inside of it. Where this device is, whether it's wherever it's located in your van. For example, like if me, I'd probably put it like right over here, not only because of the GPS, but the other stuff that is in the Waggle system. So to have a couple different GPS systems is essential, but also what is really cool about Waggle is it is a temperature and humidity monitor. Now, I haven't traveled with a dog yet because I just got Glacier, but a lot of people that have these, you know, pets that they travel with, whether it's a dog, a cat, a freaking lizard, or a dog, it doesn't matter. Having a pet monitor inside of your van or in your RV is so essential. There are a lot of places out there that are national parks that do not allow dogs, for example. You want to make sure that your furry friend is safe in the van. And this, you can set it to alert your freaking phone if the temperature gets out of control, and then you can rush back to your van and you can obviously take care of your furry friend, because you do not want your dog overheated or obviously too cold, but more so overheated than anything. So when we take these vans to national parks, we want to make sure that this system can monitor that scenario. Now, because this little device has power to it and also has a monitor built inside of it and all that other good stuff that's in there, the GPS system, obviously it needs power. And it's, you don't see really where the power is, but underneath there's a little power strip or a little like place to plug it in to charge it. You don't really need to charge this all that often. It's not like your phone or like your Apple Watch or something like that. You don't have to charge it every night. This thing will last between 4 to 6 days. So it's nice. You only have to really recharge this once a week, if you think about that. I don't have two hands available because I'm holding a camera on one, but this is actually, the device is clipped in, so the clip will attach to a wall, and then you can unclip it, charge it when you are maybe sleeping one night, and then put it back into the clip when you're all done. Super easy and simple. And then lastly about Waggle, what is really awesome about this is you do not have to rely on any type of Wi-Fi connection. This works off of the Verizon network. I have Verizon on my phone. So if my phone has service, then guess what? This has service as well. It works off that Verizon network. You are good to go there. Make sure you go and check out the link that I either put in the description below or in the comment. It'll be mywaggle.com, taking care of your pet while you're away from your van. Thank you for listening to me while I cheater chat about the Waggle. Today's Friday evening. And I don't know why I just opened that door. I thought I was gonna show you guys something, but there's really not much there. Today's packing up day. Today's kind of organizational day. I wanted to take the camera out before I go home and edit up this video. Yesterday, I got this guy done. This was a very cool project of mine. I'm gonna start making more of these, actually. This is prototype number one. This is, I am gonna have a full video on how I did this entire thing. Oh, over here, as I trip over some stuff, is actually more of, I have some more. So this will be prototype number two. I haven't done any finishing to it. It's still kind of there. You know, stay tuned. I will probably put that up for sale, either on my website or somewhere, however I do that when I start putting tables up for sale. I have a mold now, which is really exciting. I bought a mold, a silicone mold. I believe the perfect size for lagoon tables. That'll be part of the DIY, you know, section of my channel. It's gonna be like DIY projects. I just signed a contract with a really cool tool brand. You guys will be hearing a lot about that. They're enthusiasts in the DIY market, so am I. It's good stuff, yay. Check this out. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. Check this out. Bink. That's right. I took my desk at home. Well, actually, this is not my desk, but I took the idea from my desk at home and I made it into a table with lights on it. That desk at home, everybody, does not have lights built into it.
that desk at home, I put a softbox light under it, and then I posted a picture that I stepped away from it. Can't see the softbox light, but you can see the lights coming up through. That picture was reposted by several epoxy Instagram pages. With the love of that table, I felt like I can do a miniature version for Vans. And again, I'll show you guys an entire video on how I did it. So there's no light coming from underneath. The lights are on, there's no light underneath. And again, I'll explain this in the video that I do, but you can see that there's a piece of wood underneath routered in this, and then I routered in the lights. It was a crazy project. I want to see if I could do it. I did it. And you know what the coolest part about all of this is? Oh, by the way, it's battery powered. Battery pack is right there. The coolest part about all of this is when I sell my van, I'm going to give the new buyer an option. They can either take this table or they can take this table. The buyer gets to choose which one they want. I have a funny feeling they're gonna take this one over here. 100% recycled pallets. Don't have to have the lights on, obviously. You can just flick it off down here with the switch and you can have really cool colors in it. Updates on other parts of the life. I got a couple quotes from a couple different tiny like trailer companies. I have to look over both of those quotes and I have to make a decision on which one I want to go with. Right now, I am back and forth between a 20-foot design and a 22-foot design. I'm probably going to go with the 22-footer. I actually just did a little bit of research on what my summer looks like. I have something like 8 events over the next 6 months, including season 2 of Gutted. Season 1 is coming very, very soon. I believe the trailer is going to be dropping really soon. So once the trailer does drop, I will make sure to share it with everybody. I've been watching some clips from it that the producers have been sending me. Guys, Gutted is awesome. I can't wait to be a part of this long term with them. I'm gonna go home right now. I'm gonna pack up and then we're gonna hit the road. Let's go out to my boy Shane's house, because that's where Glacier's gonna be staying. And I will see you guys next time. Later.